Google reviews are packed with insights, perfect for market analysis and tracking your brand image. But collecting them manually takes ages. In this video, we'll show you how to scrape Google reviews at scale using Python and proxies. Let's get started! To follow along, make sure you have the latest version of Python, Playwright framework, and proxies to bypass IP blocks and scraping errors. If you don't have the libraries yet, install them through a terminal. Then get yourself some proxies. For scraping Google reviews, we recommend residential proxies. If you have the Decodo subscription, go to our dashboard. Under residential proxies, select residential, and in the proxy setup tab, you'll find the endpoint address, username and password, which we'll later add to the code. Now we're all set, so open a text editor of your choice and let's start typing. First, import the libraries needed. Playwright Sync API allows to use a headless Chrome-like browser through code. The following import is going to be used for generating unique IDs for each review. The CSV module will save the output as a CSV file, while the regular expression module is used to clean and extract specific parts of the text. Now, let's define the main function that will handle the entire scraping process. Inside the function, we start by storing the proxy details. Don't forget to replace these placeholders with your actual proxy credentials. The following line initializes the Playwright browser automation environment. Then, we launch the Firefox browser and apply the proxy settings. If you don't want the browser window to open, you can set headless to true. Next, we create a new browser context. This is like starting with a fresh browser profile. We'll also set the window size, locale, and headers to simulate a US-based user. Finally, open a new tab within that browser context. Now, we define what we want to scrape. Let's say we want to open a coffee shop in London and we need to scout the competition. In this case, we'll search for a Starbucks location in London and collect 20 reviews. The following variables set the Google Maps search query and how many reviews you want to collect. But you can adjust these parameters depending on your needs. We also prepare a few variables to store the scraped business name, star rating, review count, and the reviews themselves. Then, we tell the scraper to navigate to Google Maps. The code sets the interface language to English, as some elements have specific names based on the language. With this code, we dismiss the cookie consent pop-up by clicking a specific button, but if the button isn't found, it simply moves on without raising an error. Next, we locate the search bar, click it, type our query, and press enter. Then, we add a timeout to wait for a few seconds and allow results to load. The following code tries to click the first result that appears from the search. Once clicked, it again waits briefly to ensure the business profile has fully loaded. After the page opens, the script grabs the business name from the heading. The next step is to open the review section. The script does this by clicking a button labeled Reviews 4. Then, we extract the star rating and total review count. The review count text is cleaned using a regular expression to get only the digits. Let's print the business title, its rating, and how many reviews it has. If we ask for more reviews than are available, the script will adjust the number to match what's actually on the page. We also create a set to track which review IDs we've already seen. Duplicate reviews can sneak in when Google reuses elements during lazy loading. To avoid messy data, we assign IDs to each review and avoid repetitive entries. Now the script enters a loop that continues until we collect enough unique reviews. It fetches all currently visible reviews and checks for new ones. For each review element, we check if we have already met the goal. If not, we keep going. Next, if a review has a More button, expand it to get the full text. With this code, the scraper extracts the reviewer's name, then it tries to extract the star rating from a span's area label. If found, it extracts only the numeric part. There are two ways that the rating can be displayed: text or number of star icons. If the first method fails, it uses an alternative method to find the rating. Most importantly, we extract the review text. If it's empty, we use a default fallback. We can also try to get a unique ID for the review. If not found, we create one. This is done to prevent duplicates. With this code snippet, we skip already collected reviews. If successful, the code stores the review and adds the ID to the seen list. Errors are caught and logged. If no new unique reviews were found, the loop breaks early. Then, the script tries to scroll down the reviews panel. Google Maps only loads a handful of reviews at a time. So to scrape all of them, we simulate scrolling to the bottom of the review panel, triggering more content to appear.
Once we're done, we print out all the reviews in the terminal. If any error happens during the scraping process, it's caught and printed. Whether the scraping was successful or not, the browser is closed to clean up. The function then returns all the information that it collected. Then we run the script and call the scraping function. Finally, we save everything to a CSV file. First the metadata, then the headers, followed by reviews. Now save the file as a Python script and run it in your terminal. You'll see the browser open, collect the reviews, and then close automatically.
And just like that, you now have a CSV file called Google Reviews with all data you scraped. You can copy the complete code in the video description below. And don't forget to grab your free trial for Decodo residential proxies. Bye!